Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name is Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this box. This is a Ubiquiti camera. This is the AI-DSLR. So this is the top end of the AI range. It's a very specific camera. There are two variations of it. You have a specific lens that you can add to it. This is really good for long distance, for specific number plate recognition and other items like that, because it has a true normal DSLR lens that you can add to it. This is definitely not going to be a technical overview. There are a lot of parts in the box, and I really want to just show you maybe some of the bits that go together. So you are going to get your little get started guide. I would suggest that you probably do scan that code, because there's quite a lot of bits to get together. You're going to have your conformity guide there. You're probably not going to open that up and do anything else with it. You're going to get a little packet of screws and lugs. This can be wall mounted, ceiling mounted, tripod mounted. So there are quite a lot of options there. It comes with a completely separate dedicated lens. It's an Olympus lens. So you're going to get a set of books and warranty cards that are around the lens, because the lens is separate to the actual device itself. You are going to get a little storage bag here to put the lens in. Obviously, if you're going to put it in position, you're probably not going to use the bag, but it's there in the box. You will, right, let's now try and work through how we're going to show you all of this. So this is very much like a normal bullet camera. It's got all the knuckle joints and everything, but there's a casing for it all to go inside. So let's have a look. You're going to get the base portion of the camera, if you like, which is this. You're going to get your Ethernet in on this side's PoE powered device. Under this, there is an additional connector hidden away there, or a mount connector. So that's what's under there. And then here at the front, obviously you have what you would normally have on a DSLR camera. You have a lens cover case that reveals the mirror under there. All right, and then probably just a little bit more important, on the back there are these two locator holes as well. So this is the main portion of it. There's a case that I'll show you that fits around the outside of this, or you can mount these all up separately. There is a small hole in here where you can start mounting a tripod. So the idea is, so in this instance, we have an Olympus lens that came with this. All right, it's a standard 17 mil lens on this. Having a little look at the specs there, hopefully you can see. I believe this is the wide angle setup that we have. So the idea obviously is that these two pieces get connected together, just like you would with any DSLR camera. So let's just take those apart there. Obviously, red dot on the front here is going to match the red dot on the top there as we connect those up. All right, so this essentially is our camera setup. This is the main portion of our device. Once we've got those connected together, then we have all the other bits like we would do with a normal bullet camera. So if we're going to put this inside, maybe you don't want to have it in the housing, then again, you can screw the first portion of the knuckle joint on. Try and show you that, haven't done it all the way up, but obviously our knuckle joint gives us that type of action, and depending on how you move it, you get quite a lot of other movement in there. And you do get a brace that can you actually do this up even more solid. Obviously, I've left in the bung here, which you'd need to take out in this instance for mounting it. So what the next bit is this can all fit inside some housing. So we're gonna take off our bung off here, all right? And we now get another shroud, another cover to go around this. And you'll actually see here, there's again another tripod mount here if you wanted to tripod mount this outside. So what we can now actually do is, I'm going to actually just take the lens off here. So I'm going to push this button in and just undo our lens, just so that I can do this probably with a little less fear in my mind as we do this. So I don't know whether you'll be able to actually see, but in the top of there are two pins. And those line up with the holes that I showed you in here. So our device is basically going to push back inside the housing and it comes out of the back here. You can see, hopefully if the camera does focus, there we go. And now again, I can connect my, and hopefully it's going to show you what I'm doing. Now we can connect up our knuckle joint again. All right, and there we go. So that's our base. Now if we connect back our lens, let me just take the cover off here a minute, which does not want to come off this time around. Come on, cover. All right, so the cover has decided it's not going to come off. All right, so I'm going to probably have to show you this without the cover being out of here. Hang on a minute, let me just push the camera out. I think the lens cover has got the lens release button stuck. So let's just release that. There we go. Hopefully that will do it. There we go, lens cover is off. Let me just push that back inside the housing nicely again. This obviously is going to go on the outside of this to hold it into place, but it's now just playing around slightly. There we go. All right, so now we can do this up onto the bottom here. Okay, let's reattach our lens. So our lens now is connected again. All right, so then we have a further shroud for this. This can now fit over the top, probably with the lens cover off. All right, and now with the lens cover off, we can now screw our cover back into place on here. Here we go. All right, and now we have our fully watertight, I've not done it up totally, but fully watertight camera. You can see the camera is neatly in there. We've obviously got our knuckle joint. Now this is heavy now, so you're gonna need a good lot of support on there. Or you do have a tripod mount that you can put onto the bottom there as well. We can now carry on with a couple of other bits. We get a traditional pole mount. I'm not sure I would trust this to be pole mounted, but you could pole mount this and then you obviously have your standard plate here to mount it onto the wall. All right, so that will go onto there to complete it up. Your cable will pass through the middle, will pass through here. You can see we've got a gland for the Ethernet cable to pass through to seal it. You do have a couple more in the box there as well, which will help complete that off. And you do actually have a further back mount here. If you weren't going to mount it, you're going to put it on a tripod. This could be replaced on the back here directly, just with the Ethernet cable coming in, and will give you everything that's watertight. With the lens, you did get another sun cover. All right, obviously that's not going to fit inside this. And it would be more if you had used that exposed. So wow, that is quite a lot of parts. This is the AI DSLR camera from Ubiquiti. This is the wide angle version, put all inside its weatherproof housing. Hopefully that's been useful. Head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got plenty more box openings on wireless network and firewall devices. What do I need to set up Unify Protect, for instance, or Unify Network? So do subscribe and stay up to date.